Everybody, welcome back to Skylanders Spyro's Adventure. I actually had this weird glitch happen where Gilgrunt actually wouldn't warp back into the portal, but after some online searching, I did a fix, so he is back. The only thing is his progress reset, but only the first chapter anyway. But we're about ready for chapter 2, so let's talk to Flynn.
Yeah, I'm sure Cali will be thrilled to meet me. And who can blame her, huh? So, you ready to shove off, you big sky what's it?
Alright, so let's go.
Yep, I'll have this Cali eaten out of the palm of my hand in no time. And who can blame her? I mean, look at me! Boom! You see how I was able to hit that? That takes years of practice and skill. I know, amazing, right? Well, you can thank me later. I think we should find this Cali as soon as possible. It's just not fair to deny the girl the pleasure of meeting me. I'll scout from overhead. Meanwhile, you see if you can find her on the ground.
Okay, so Flynn's gone. Our main objective here is to find Cali, who's one of the NPCs that will help you out in the game. You'll see what she does if you don't know.
Different areas of Skylands have different elemental energies. When you switch to using Skylanders of the same element in that area, they will have extra power and reap extra rewards.
Okay.
Skylanders of the tech element are stronger in this zone.
So it's like Eon said, if you use the mentioned element, there's like extras. One of the things that happens is, like, when you attack enemies, you actually do more damage with the mentioned element. So, let's go with tech. I'm actually going to warp in Drill Sergeant. Oh, I should also mention, if you have, there's something called an adventure pack, which actually opens up, has a Skylander, opens up a new area, and it comes with some items for the game. The Pirate Seas Adventure Pack comes with this right here, the hidden treasure. You should, if you have this, keep it on your portal like at all times, because you actually get like a free treasure chest. It's indicated on the bottom there. Oh, here it is. It's basically free money. There's actually a little glitch in the Wii version, or exploit, whatever you want to call it. If you pick up the treasure chest and open it up and talk to an NPC, it'll respawn in the same area. It's pretty nice if you want more money. Okay, so I've actually never used Drill Sergeant, so let's see. Drill rockets and this thing. It's awesome. Okay. You can actually nickname your Skylanders. I would definitely give him the nickname, was it Grounder? Is that what it's called? The enemy from Sonic with the drill hands, from Sonic 1 and I think 2. Or here's a new enemy, Chompy Pod. These plants basically just spit out Chompies in here. Oh, here's another one. Dro Spearman. These guys are all pretty easy. I mean, the plants don't really hurt you, they just keep spitting out the Chompies. Sometimes it gets annoying, but you can actually take these out, because they don't move, so. Now, the Drow Spearmans aren't that easy, they just actually attack you. They have better range than the Chompies. Alright. Last one here. There we go. If you notice, there's like a bunch of sheep running around. Oh wait, there's can drop down. Oh no, this is where we came from. That's right. Anyway, the sheep, I'm guessing that it's like a subtle reference to the previous Spyro series, the main Spyro series. Because there were sheep in there that acted what they called fodder. When you, like, basically killed them, you get, like, health and stuff like that. I mean, there's some other references to... Oh, wait, there's a path down here, too. Other references to the classic Spyro series, too, like, there's the presence of Flynn. He's a balloonist in the Spyro games. I know the first one, I don't remember offhand if they're in the second and third ones, but balloonists are how you got to each area. Here's the cowboy hat. That would look kind of dumb on Drill Sergeant, so... Yes. Okay, let's go back down here. I know there's an area over here, too. So there's a bunch of other places here. One thing that's cool about this game is, I mean, there's a lot of exploration you can do. Let's try a chest right here. Oh, yeah. Before each chapter, I should have mentioned it at the beginning, but I set aside certain Skylanders because in each area there's like three specific elements that you need to access every area. This one is tech, life, and water. If you just have the starter pack, you'll have... Oh wait, here's the surgeon. It's for Thumb Smash. You'll have two of the three, just not the life one. Okay, so the soul gem for Thumb Smash, let's preview him. Yeah, he was one of those ones that I didn't like at first, but he's actually pretty cool. He's incredibly slow, but he's useful once you upgrade him. I just want to go back because I think I missed something. I'm liking Drill Sergeant so far. When the game first came out, in North America, you can only get Drill Sergeant in Walmart stores. I don't really shop there, so I never got that one. But eventually was released, like, everywhere. After, was it like 3 months or something like that? Or two. Two or three. Whirlwind in the US was exclusive to Target stores. Alright, I think I'm done here. He reminds me exactly of the Grounder, I think his name is, from Sonic. I think those who have played the classic Sonic games probably remember what I'm talking about. He was in the cartoon, too. The Scratch and Grounder, like, one was a drill guy, the other was the annoying chicken guy. Okay, so let's head in. These turtle puzzles are, like, extremely easy. I mean, there's some slightly more complicated ones later on in the game, but for the most part, they're really easy. You kind of encounter them every once in a while. And he dropped the cheese pizza. Or, no, that was a pepperoni pizza. Yeah, I mean, obviously the food just replenishes your health. There's different types of food. They don't really have any major differences, I don't think. Okay, so somebody magic. Who haven't I used yet? Oh! Let's go with this one here. There's another one I've never used before. This is Double Trouble. Okay. He summons... Oh, here's a story circle. Well, let me kill this first. Oh, that's cool. So he has like a magic spell, his A button attack and his B button, he summons like a little version of him, I guess, that attacks enemies. There's actually another Skylander like that. Sonic Boom. She can summon, oh, they're like colored purple, that's crazy. She can summon kids to attack enemies. Yeah, let's get this.
A note from Hugo says, sheep are among the most feared creatures in Skylands. Those Mabu, having fallen asleep while counting large herds of sheep, often discover their belongings missing when they wake up. When questioned, of course, the sheep never admit to having taken anything.
Well, that's just silly. Anyway, we have another turtle to deal with here. Wow, Double Trouble is really slow. It's cool so far, but he's extremely slow. Especially when compared to Drill Sergeant, because he can use that drill attack. Oops. He has to be put back. But yeah, this game, I remember when it was announced at E3 2011, I saw it, and, you know, honestly, it looked okay, but I was just like, oh, they really changed the Spyro series. But it wasn't until, like, when the game came out, my friend Paul, he bought the game, and he live-streamed it on his Twitch TV account. I saw it, and I'm like, wow, this game looks really cool. I didn't end up buying it, I started out with a 3DS version, which I bought in January, and then I didn't buy the Wii version until, like, maybe a month later.
But, know that you don't have to do this all alone, Portal Master.
Okay, this part I have to mention because it's very confusing. So you see a spot right here. Okay, I found this completely on accident. It was like a coincidence. But there's actually a thing you can access over there. You see those vines? You need a life Skylander, though. When I did this the first time, well, actually, no, the second time I went through this level, because I was trying to find, there's an item in here that you need. You actually need a life Skylander, and I happen to be using Stump Smash the second time. Stump Smash or Stealth Elf? Anyway, when you walk over here, you automatically generate a bridge. So you can walk across. And this is Camo. I actually haven't used him yet. That's pretty cool. Shoots out these beams and then the plants as his B attack. And we have, oh, there's a legendary treasure. Okay, it's a Enigma pig. I was about to call it a steel sheep, but okay. He's pretty cool so far. Like, his A attack reminds me of Spyro's fireballs. His B attack is actually unique. Nobody else has an attack like that. Okay. Oh, these locks, you have to hop in this, you have to shoot them off. I will do that in just a moment. I'm going to backtrack a little bit, see if I missed anything. But yeah, I started out with a 3DS version, and here's Flynn again.
Hey, I found Cali, and she's not half bad. Oh yeah, and she's been captured by a bunch of evil drow. We gotta save her so she can get on with more important things, like thanking me. Boom! Over there, that cannon looks like it could be useful. But if you climb inside the turret, you can shoot the locks on the gate.
And there's Cali. But yeah, I started out with the 3DS version. As I mentioned before, it's actually a completely different game. In that version, you can actually, like, all the Skylanders can jump. In this one, you can only jump, Okay, I actually need to backtrack a little bit farther. No, I'm gonna switch to Drill Sergeant, because he can move a lot faster. And all the Skylanders that game can run as well. You know, at different speeds, but they can all run. And jump. I would compare the 3DS version to... Oh wait, I can't backtrack. Shoot. I might be missing out on a hat. Maybe. That kind of stinks. Oh, there's a treasure chest there. If I miss out on the hat, I'm just going to go back to the level and just grab it. But the 3DS version is more like... It's more of a traditional platform. This one's like a platformer with, like, beat-em-up type elements, I guess, with the fighting. The 3DS version has stuff like that, but it's more of a platformer, like, because of all the jumping and stuff. Alright, so I gotta shoot off all the blocks. Alright, simple enough. There's some more shooting sections like that in the game. They kind of vary in fun.
Wait. You're a Skylander, aren't you? This is unbelievable! I was just rescued by a real Skylander.
And, me? I helped.
Flynn the Balloonist here. That's me at your service.
Charming.
Yes, yes, I know. Must be pretty overwhelming for you to finally meet the best pilot in all of Skylands.
You know, I didn't need any help back there. I had them right where I wanted them.
Sure you did.
Whatever.
Well, yes, ma'am. You are welcome.
Okay, so, yeah, I missed out on a hat. What I'm going to do is after I continue here, the cutscene's going to play, whatever, I'm going to go back to the level and pick up that hat. And maybe this treasure chest, I don't know.
Back! Back, you vile beast!
Honestly, Hugo, they're just sheep.
That is where you are wrong, my dear Cali. These creatures may appear to be friendly, cuddly piles of fluff, but turn your back on them and they turn into wretched lint balls with beady little eyes staring at your every move.
Sorry about the lint balls, Hugo, but we were able to rescue Cali.
Actually, it was the Skylander who rescued...
Oh! Oh, Cali! Stop with the praise. It's embarrassing, entirely appropriate.
But embarrassing! Hey, could we please get on to the important things? While you were all away, I found the old blueprints for the Core of Light. The ancients used them when they first built it.
Wait a second. I thought you said you built the Core of Light.
Well, yes and no. Yes, I said that I did, but no, I really didn't. The old core was used to repel the forces of darkness. If we can rebuild a new core of light, it should stop Chaos from his wicked plan to rule Skylands. And then we can focus on getting rid of those villainous sheep. The Far Viewer will help us find the parts we need to rebuild the core, but this cursed overgrown bramble is blocking it off. Could you assist us, Great One? Clearing the bramble could give us a clue to the whereabouts of the eternal sources we need.
Now you can find a special hidden dragon treasure.
Okay, I will clear out the bramble in the beginning of the next video. Here's a hidden treasure here. It is funny because it actually popped up during the cutscene there. Like popped out of the ground. Oh, wait. Maybe... Okay, yeah, we can just do it here. Alright, so, traveling back to Chapter 2 to grab that hat. I did mention about maybe grabbing the treasure, but I don't know if I'll actually do that. The thing with those is, like, if you explore, like, every nook and cranny, you'll find every treasure chest. The treasure chests, to me, aren't that important. Oops. Let me skip this.
Now you can find a special hidden dragon.
Oh, here's the treasure from before. Oh yeah, if you didn't know, on the Wii version, you can hit the C button to skip any, like, conversation or cutscene. I don't remember if the manual actually tells you that, but you can do that. Okay, I do remember the exact spot that I skipped over. If you remember, I did that, I went over that bridge with the Life Skylander. In my case, it was camo. End up skipping, like, this whole section over here. So, let's get rid of the chompy pods if we can actually explore a little bit. The only thing is, this gate has that key, so I have to find that. I always thought that animation was cool. When you level up, you, like, grow big for a moment. I mean, it doesn't hurt the enemies, but it just looks cool. Okay. Let's move him back. These two always spawn whenever you do that. There we go. Oh, right down there, you can actually see that block puzzle. That's what we didn't get to. Honestly, if you're gonna do this level, you can still do that life thing, but I would advise actually doing this path first.
Know that you don't have to be alone.
Okay. If you notice, there's a whirlpool on the bottom there. We can go there too. Need the water. That's where I mentioned you need the water sky before. Alright, let's open this up. See, right up here, that's where we were before, but it's a dead end. You actually can't turn back to this area here, so. Yeah. Actually, I wonder if you can do that both in one run. I'm trying to think if you can. If not, it doesn't, you know, hurt to come back here. And the main advantage is you can get more treasures and stuff like that. Okay, so we're going to use Gilgrunt. Let's use Whamshell. He is my latest and last acquisition for Skylanders. Again, I actually have never used him before. So. He shoots out like a starfish. That's cool. Okay, the block puzzle. For a lot of these, they're not, you know, particularly difficult. It's just like a guess and test type thing. Trial and error, whatever you want to call it. For a lot of these puzzles, I don't remember the exact, like, solutions. Mostly you're going to see me just, like, moving them around, stuff like that, and hopefully eventually find the solution, but I don't know, like, I haven't memorized, like, exactly what you're supposed to do, so. Just letting you know in advance. The treasure chest I grabbed before this and this one, that would make all three treasure chest appearances in the level. Three of them. Okay, I need to move something closer. Oh, here. I won't be able to grab that, but that's not a big deal. It's just a little bit. See, what you want to do is drop down here and make your way to that teleport pad thing. So you can access this, the hat that we didn't get. And this is the birthday hat. That would look dumb on Whamshell, so I'm not gonna equip it. Alright, so that's pretty much it. I'm gonna continue the level, but I'm gonna end the video here because there's really nothing else to show. So, next video, we're going to head to Chapter 3. So, thanks for watching. Hope to see you next time.